Thank you. this instrument, which had been out for renovation, and as well to finally see the magnificent renovation of this church space also. The acoustic and the instrument together are really remarkable. So I hope that you are enjoying the program. And in the second half, we will explore two composers. First, my friend and colleague from the Montreal area, Rachel Laura, who is herself an amazing organ virtuoso and composer, who has done so much to augment the repertoire of the organ as a female composer in our time. She's written symphonies and just countless pieces for the instrument, all filled with charm and humor. So I've selected three small pieces to continue to highlight on this instrument the beauty and variety of the flute stops. So you'll hear 4-foot and 8-foot flutes and 2-foot flutes and so forth. And these pieces are just marvelous as miniatures in highlighting the various flute colors that we have on this instrument. Sometimes I'll play things up or down the octave where they're written in order to just make the most of the beauty of the colors of the flutes in all areas of the keyboard compass. And finally, we will conclude the program with a set of late works from Johann Sebastian Bach from the end of his life. First two chorale preludes from his compendium, his collection, Klavierübung, or what's often called the German organ mass, the magnificent Kyrie Gott Heiliger Geist, which if there are any organists in the crowd, I will play this piece in a rather unorthodox way to explore the depth of sound as much as I can pull out of this particular instrument. And the beautiful Canon D. Cindy Heiligen saying about these are the holy 10 commandments where the chorale tune is heard in canon along against a beautiful lilting accompaniment. And finally, the great primitive fugue in E minor. The fugue is called The Wedge. That was not Bach's title. It was given that later because the fugue theme starts from a single note, the E, in the key of E minor.